Kiyra Lynn with Hollywood First Look, and today I'm sitting down with director Ryan Crego, Michael J. Woodard, and Mary Lambert to talk about their new Netflix animated film, ARLO the Alligator Boy. Let's take a first look.
Happy birthday, darling baby boy. You're old enough to know the truth.
I have a dad from a city called New York.
This is your adventure.
But I want more, 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 'cause I know that I can have it. I know I'm gonna get it one day.
My name's Birdie.
My name's Arlo Beauregard.
I'm Berlisha. This is teeny tiny Tony.
It's just Tony, but okay.
Marcella's in the house, yes! And Aaliyah up front is our driver.
Aaliyah?
Yeah?
Ain't you driving the bus?
Yeah.
Should we buckle our seatbelts?
Yeah, you probably should.
Ryan, Michael, and Mary, how are you today?
Hello. Oh, good.
Ryan, I'm going to start with you. Congratulations, director, first animated feature. Mm-hmm. But you're also the writer of this story. Mm-hmm. So I would love for you to tell me where you found the inspiration for the heart in ARLO when writing this.
You know, I have been working on the story for a decade. Off and on. Wow. So it's like, you know, it's been with me. I thought about it for a long time. And the character really came out of drawing and sketching and it kind of, he started speaking to me, I think, in a weird way. I'm not crazy, but I might be, you know, but yeah, so really I started kind of building a world around this character that I fell in love with. I fell in love with drawing him, and I loved the expressions that I was getting and all of the vulnerability that I saw in this character. And, ultimately became a character that I really wanted to put into the world, but wanted to put into the world with a sense of joy and optimism and positivity, a character who would be the best part of ourselves. You know, we all want to be good. We all want to be optimistic. It's hard sometimes, but so, you know, there's that piece of ourselves that's always pushing forward. And ARLO is that, you know, in the story. I think there's a whole cast of characters and they're all, you know, some are more extreme than others, but they all have these, you know, very big personalities, and I think they're all kind of pieces of me in the writing process. But ARLO is that like pure heart that you always want to like push forward. And so the goal being, you know, that the audience sees this and just roots, you know, you just root for him. You want him to succeed. You know that his intentions are good. And I believe that, you know, most of us are, we want that for ourselves in life, so.
Michael, I would love to know, for you creatively, how is it recording music for a movie, for a character, as opposed to recording music in the studio for yourself? Is it different creatively?
Well, I would say the only difference is probably being able to write the music, but that's literally the only difference. The creative process in terms of me giving my vocals to the song weren't very different. It's funny because my team that I work with in terms of my own solo music, when they listen to Shock, they're like, okay, this doesn't go, you know, straight too far left, you know, from what you actually do when you're in the studio. And I'll blame that on Ryan because he and Alex Karengas, who really allows us to bring who we are artistically to the acting and the music. So I think that creatively the process was not very different, other than writing the material, but I need to write this material. This material is prime.
I'm gonna make sure you get to your dad safe and sound.
Follow, 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 follow me home.
Mary, Birdie is such a joy and that best friend to ARLO. And I would love to know, are we gonna see more of her in I Heart ARLO?
Yes, oh my gosh. It has been so much fun recording the series. And you know, that was the one, I mean, really minute upside to this last year was the fact that we could do everything remotely because it was animation. So, you know, both Michael and I think, you know, record our own stuff and our, you know, have, you know, our have experience doing that. So I have a little studio here and I was really lucky to be able to do a lot of the records from my, you know, I just roll out of bed and do them. And the song, I'm telling you, the songs in the series are out of control. And so, like, I just can't wait for everyone to hear them. And I want to talk about them and talk about the storylines. And I have to be professional.
Arlo the Alligator Boy is streaming on Netflix now. Congratulations, you guys. I'm out of time, but this was superb.
Make sure you get to your dad safe and sound.
Follow me home.
Looks like you got out of the swamp.
We got a real safe place for you to stay.
Don't you threaten me with a good time, honey.
Whoa!
Hey, yo!
It's a whole city to explore.
Hey, I'm walking
here!
Lucky!
I'm walking here.
I risk everything to be here. Y'all don't even know who I am.
Because of you, I think that different is the best thing someone can be.
Birdie, it's the best friend rock.
That's a seashell. See?
Oh my word, now we can have matching best friend rocks.
I love it.